in Africa, they would always take inert things that weren't poisonous, and they would always make soups or stews. Yeah. So they started grinding them in moles and using them for spices. Wasn't very long, right? Some of the beans fell into the fire, right? And then roasted, and then coffee was born. Lots of people I work with thought I was crazy. You get to that point where it's diabolical. How do I take this one little bean and bring those oils to the most beautiful caramelization to where it finally goes into that cup and somebody's like, I can't believe something that came from that little tree tastes this good. Experimentation, constant experimentation, and sampling different coffees with lots of people. Slowly you're roasting it at different profiles, looking for that really beautiful dark brown, rusty gold. Not something easily palatable and very fast, right? But very complex. And in that first crack that you hear is that oil pushing so hard against that meniscus, it splits. After just a minute or two, it's almost as if the coffee comes alive. Then add people into the mix and give them some tables to communicate, right? Mm-hmm. And now you have a culture. I mean, even a cowboy had coffee at the campfire, you know what I mean? Coffee's a social drink, right? Mm-hmm. The whole community has signed this wall for ownership. Those signatures on the wall, the decorations, everyone has shared a piece of their life in here. It's an absolute time capsule. And that tells the story of the community that we live in here in Douglasville. It's a beautiful community. You learn a lot about people, and you learn, I think, more about yourself. It's the expression on the people's faces, and it's the camaraderie. And if I can be a part of creating that thing that triggers that point that does that, I think that's where I get excited. By reaction of the comments at your counter, you find that perfect roast, like an artist who needs to feed off the community. That's where those ideas come from, for somebody to really create something beautiful. And I was never home, maybe 2 days a month. I had no time to really have a life outside of work because I was busy working on a contract for a large telecommunications company. I had all these excuses for why what I was doing was sustainable and practical. You're so complacent being locked into something for so long, right? And success wasn't going to be measured in the end about how much you've accumulated in the end, but how happy are you actually? Are you really happy? If it wasn't for coffee, I'd still be searching for another way. I think coffee was a vehicle for me. Now I feel like I'm a part of the community. How do you take something so simple and turn it into something potentially magnificent? That's the art of it. It hasn't really changed from then to now. I don't have a roaster where there's computers and bells and whistles and little nuances that do it all for you. I tend to have a tendency to want to do it on my own with all my senses. How do you improve on something 2,000 years old? And that aroma and that color and the weight of the bean during the roasting time will tell a lot about how that coffee finishes out. Some people are weekend warriors, right? And they take off for the lake or they go out hunting. That's what they're working all week to do. I open that door first thing in the morning and it's like Willy Wonka in the chocolate factory almost. Now really it is. It's you're going back and you're grabbing a hold of your beans and you're creating that wonderful thing. Or I get to make my own coffees and I get to create things. Two different roasters, same coffee, two completely different results. And actually that's beautiful. You're bringing something exciting. something nobody else has yet sampled until you're finished roasting it. In the end, being able to look back, no matter how much I have or I don't have, I was able to do something in my life and accomplish something that actually made me happy. Having a dream, right? And always wanting to do something, right? But you can never quite figure out how to get there. And now I'm here, right? And it's reality. Absolute bliss.